Episode number 9, Juliet Kidnapped.
Juliet, are you here? Oh, my Juliet. Where can she be? Oh, she stood me up.
Ah, D'Artagnan is in love. But he's not the only one who awaits Juliet's return with great concern and impatience.
Where is she? Oh. I can't understand what could have delayed her so. I hope nothing unfortunate has befallen her. I don't know why I worry so much. My niece knows how to take care of herself. And that nice D'Artagnan is with her. No, she wouldn't do anything foolish. But then again, you can't trust young people nowadays. What am I saying? No, no. Juliet's not that kind of girl. She's sensible. Ah, here she comes.
Wait.
What is it?
Is your name Bonacieux? Is your niece called Juliet?
That's right. Who are you, monsieur?
That hardly matters. Your niece is in my hands.
Oh, what's happened? Where's my Juliet?
Do not worry. No harm will come to her if you follow my instructions. Yeah! Yeah!
Wait! Wait! Please! Mon Dieu! How can this be?
Planchette, it's me, D'Artagnan. Open the door.
How did it go with your date?
Awful, just awful.
Oh, there are always minor disappointments in love. They're not important.
Well, they're important to me, Planchette, and I think I'm gonna cry.
Oh, there, there, monsieur.
Ah, D'Artagnan is back. I hope Juliet's with him.
Now then, sit here and relax, master.
Oh, D'Artagnan, where's Juliet?
Oh.
Weren't you with her just now?
I waited and waited and waited, but she never came.
And I know what's happened. Oh.
How can he know anything? Who's he?
The owner of the house, Monsieur Bonacieux. Please forgive him. I don't know what's come over him.
Has he come for the rent? Forgive me. I must have forgotten. Tell me how much I owe, Monsieur Bonacieux. I'll pay. There, now. That should be plenty.
Monsieur!
What on earth are you talking about?
I'm sorry, monsieur, but that's all that I have. So you'll just have to wait for the rest.
Never mind about that. Please listen to me now. They have kidnapped Juliet.
I never want to hear the name Juliet again. Huh? What do you mean they've kidnapped Juliet?
Yes, I'm afraid it's true.
What? Let me see then. Do not bother to look for your niece. You'll never find her. We will release her within a few days, just the time we need to settle a very important matter. If you talk, you will never see her again. When did they give you this message?
Just now, before he came up to see you. The man who brought it seemed like a gentleman and had a black mustache.
Sacre bleu, that man again. But why would he want to kidnap Juliet? Do you have any idea, monsieur?
I might be mistaken. It's only an assumption. But it must have something to do with the Queen. Juliet has on many an occasion been Her Majesty's confidant and go-between.
Well, whatever the reason, the black mustache is gonna regret this. Planchette, we'll find her.
Yes, sir.
I'll follow him to the gates of Hades if I have to. Sandy! I'm sorry I woke you, but I need you. Let's go, Planchette.
Yes, sir.
It's useless, my son. You'll never find her.
Oh, but I have a plan. Smell this, Sandy. It belongs to Juliet, and you'll take us right to her, won't you?
Oh, what a perfectly wonderful plan, Master.
I want to go with you, D'Artagnan.
No, monsieur. You mustn't do anything to make them suspect you. Now, trust me, I'm gonna save Juliet, I promise.
Let me help you up, Master.
Now.
And so Sandy, the only living horse with the nose of a thoroughbred bloodhound, leads our hero and Planchette through the streets of Paris on a hunt for Juliet. The kidnappers must have traveled this way, but how far did they take her? And is she safe?
Sandy, my friend, what is it? I see, Sandy. Looks like he went into the river to throw us off the track. That scoundrel crossed the river near here. But where? You won't get away with this, you ruffian.
Nothing will stop D'Artagnan from rescuing his lady. Not rain, nor thunder, nor the deep gloom of night.
No use searching any further. The rain has washed away all the tracks. What bad luck, sir.
We'll rest a while and continue later, all right, Planchette?
Yes, sir.
This time of day, I must warn you to calm down and be patient.
I could swear I heard somebody yell. Nope, I guess it was just a snores.
Keep quiet! Don't try anything foolish. This ledge is quite high, and if you fall, you might hurt yourself. You should try to sleep. Time will go faster that way, perhaps.
So that silly lady-in-waiting hasn't yet said a single word, eh?
That is so, Eminence.
Well, well, that is a pity. We may be forced to resort to more drastic measures.
It might be best to be patient.
What?
That young lady is the link between the Queen and the Duke of Buckingham. Now that she's disappeared, they will both be quite nervous. With the girl missing, they'll have no way to communicate, and then they will make the wrong move. It would be better for us to let them hang themselves. I have prepared a plan so they will fall into our hands.
Well, may I hear it at once?
Of course, Eminence.
Get help! I know!
What does Juliet have in mind? How can she possibly let our hero D'Artagnan know of her predicament? Unluckily, D'Artagnan and his trusty servant Planchette are fast asleep from their exhausting search. How can Juliet's plan work if no one sees her desperate signal? Ah, it seems there is someone awake, after all.
If only I could get word to D'Artagnan. Uh-oh.
What are you up to now, girl?
Oh, nothing. I was looking out the window. I'm sure D'Artagnan is coming to rescue me soon, to take me home.
I assure you, it is impossible to find this hiding place, so you can look out that window till your eyes pop.
Oh. That horse! I'm sure he belongs to D'Artagnan. Take him this token from me, please.
Here, I brought you something to eat.
I won't eat a bite.
You're a very stubborn young lady. Very well, then.
Help me, dear Lord.
Huh? Mon Dieu, that was D'Artagnan's horse.
Oh, keep still, Sandy. Leave me alone. But what on earth is the matter with you, you clumsy animal? Huh? What's that in your mouth?
Where could he have found it, monsieur?
I don't know, but I've seen it before. Oh, this is Juliet. Where did you find this, Sandy? Take me to her!
I'm so glad you're here, sir.
Where is the girl?
She tried to escape, sir. I had to restrain her and take her up there.
Very well. But we cannot keep her in this house very much longer.
Oh? Why?
Because I saw that meddling country bumpkin's horse on my way here.
It cannot be.
He's breathing down our necks. He never brings me anything but trouble.
We could use the firearms, monsieur.
No, I have a better idea. I'm going to laugh in that country bumpkin's face.
Is this it, Sandy? The charade is over, you ruffians. Open up! Planchette, Sandy, don't just stand there. Come on and help!
Yes, right away, master. Coming.
Now, I'll count to three and we'll break the door down. And one, two, three!
And what are you doing here, you country bumpkin?
It's the black mustache.
But I'm afraid you were a little late, my dear fellow. I'm taking your friend Juliet away with me.
Help me, Planchette.
Yes, sir. Right away, sir.
Up. Sandy, let's go.
We've managed to trick your friend. I must say he is brave and intelligent, but he'll never match my Lord Rochefort's wits.
Halt, you coward! Come back and fight like a man!
Is that clear? If anyone dares to cross you, dispose of him.
Yes, Your Eminence. Quite clear.
May God be with you.
I do not deserve such treatment, Eminence. You have entrusted your mission to a guardsman, leaving me out of your service.
Whittemore, I have not decided as yet what I shall do with you.
Eminence, I am your slave.
I've told you 1,000 times to lock yourself up in your house. You've disobeyed me. Go at once.
Yes, Your Eminence. Halt! One moment! Wait! I demand to know the nature of the mission which the Cardinal has given you. That's an order.
I have my orders from the Cardinal, and they are a secret.
What are you saying? You refuse to obey your captain?
Out of the way!
Go! Nobody cares for me.
Poor Sandy, you're done in, aren't you, my friend? You're all bruised and battered and tired. And what's more, we have lost track of my Juliet.
We'll find her.
Ah, he stopped pursuing me. This mission is over now. Farewell, Juliet.
Dry I am. Get out of my way, stoop. Blasted, even the stupid rocks are against me. Well, when they have to meet in hiding, there's something to hide. Let's find out their little secret.
This is a poem that I wrote today. My two eyes have ceased to see any light but that of thy presence, and my ears have ceased to hear any music but that of thy song.
Ah, how very romantic. I didn't think I would be this lucky.
What do you want from us?
Walk on, and don't put up a fight.
Let's do as he says, and don't worry. Nothing bad is going to happen. Now come along.
His Eminence will surely be grateful to me for this. May I beg Your Majesty and the Duke of Buckingham to stop for a moment, please?
Huh? What did you say?
Aramis, I think I made another mistake.
But it is Whittemore. So it seems that the Captain in Chief of the Guardsmen of the Prime Minister of France has nothing better to do with his time than to spy on lovers and listen to their flattering remarks.
You are despicable.
I shall teach you, monsieur, to respect a lady and not to offend her. Apologize this very instant.
Forgive me, madam, please. I'm sorry.
My God, Aramis, let him go.
I humbly beg your pardon, madam. And you, monsieur, thank your stars that I'm in no mood to fight.
The deuce. D'Artagnan, where are you going at this hour?
Aramis, how are you?
Is there anything wrong? You don't look terribly happy. Any problem you can't solve? Perhaps I can be of assistance in some way. Huh?
And so the plot thickens. Poor D'Artagnan is sad and alone as he trudges back to Monsieur Bonacieux's house. Will he ever see his beloved Juliet again?
Juliet!
One thing alone is certain, and that is the code of honor and chivalry which binds the musketeers. All for one, and one for all. D'Artagnan will persist in his fight to save Juliet from her kidnappers, but will he succeed? And if she does escape, can she evade the Cardinal's watchful guards and arrive in Paris in time to carry out her special mission?